Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I just want to say before I start this video that if I seem like uber highlighted in the center of my face, let me tell you something that I did. My dumbass went to use this Lorac Pro contour highlight palette and to set my under eyes and the bridge of my nose and my chin and the center of my forehead like I usually do. I use like the banana powder or this one, and instead I reached into this one. So if you guys don't or aren't familiar with this palette in particular, or don't know about highlighter and contour, then you won't care or get this. But for those of you that do know what this is like a shimmer highlight, like straight up white, shimmery, reflective highlight, and I set my center of the face with it. So that was a hot mess. Like I almost had to take off my entire makeup. I kind of wanted to, but for the sake of filming the videos that I have to film today, like I couldn't be bothered. So if the center of my face looks like, whoa, you like highlighted way too much, that is not cute, then you know why, and I'm just way too lazy to do my makeup over. But yeah, let me stop rambling because this is not a makeup video. This is actually my 4-month post-op VSG update. So I'm really excited to share with you guys new things that have been happening, what I've been eating, non-skill victories, how much I've lost, and things like that. So if you're interested in my 4-month update post-VSG surgery, then just keep on watching. Okay, let's go over some of the details and the stats. So today that I'm filming this, it's April 4th, 2017. My date of surgery was November 29th, 2016, and as of today, for my surgery, I have lost 63 pounds. So that is absolutely amazing. I'm completely mind blown every time I do these little statistics because I'm just really, really happy that it's working and I'm doing well and stuff like that. But I will talk about a lot of pros and cons in this video. So it's not all sunshine and butterflies, as you guys may know. So I'm gonna talk about everything. So yeah, so my start date, well, date of surgery was my highest weight. I did not have a pre-op diet. I was 322 pounds. As of today, I am 259 pounds. So that is absolutely amazing. If I didn't say it in my previous video, I think I did, I'm not really sure. I got my surgery from Advanced Laparoscopic Associates in Hackensack University Medical Center here in New Jersey. So for those of you guys who wanted to know that, and yeah, so I got it November 29th, 2016. I was 322, now I'm 259. Total weight loss as of now is 63 pounds. I will say this month, month by month, the way that, how do I word this actually? I have been losing weight a lot slower than initially. So I've seen a huge decrease in the amount of pounds per month that I've lost. And I mean, if you focus on that, you're gonna be like, you know, a Debbie Downer, and try not to focus on the numbers so much, because I will say that I am losing way more inches than I am pounds. And I can't tell you how many people come up to me and it's like, it's all in your face, it's all in your face. And that's really nice. I mean, I would like it to spread out all the other areas, but you know, they see a noticeable difference, which makes me feel better, because sometimes you can forget when you focus on the numbers or fixate on the numbers that you are indeed, you know, going through a drastic change in your body. I don't know if that makes sense. I was kind of rambling. But yeah, the weight is going down, but it's going down very slowly now. So I know it will pick up. I know it will fluctuate. And I know that because I watch videos like this and I hear other people's stories. So I'm just trying to let you guys know that if you're going through the same thing, or you're going to get this surgery, or you're in the beginning stages, or if you've hit a plateau, do not worry. Try your hardest. Work your hardest, use your tool to its advantage. It will pick up. This is more of like a fluctuating type of thing. It's not gonna be like drastic weight loss all the time. You get what I mean? Just have more patience is basically what I'm trying to say. So yeah, as I said before, I'm definitely losing a lot more inches than anything. I feel like I should be tracking my inches. I just don't have it for the day of surgery. Like, I don't think I recorded my inches. I have to look back on that. But yeah, I have to start measuring myself and seeing, you know, how much I've lost in inches. But just to put things in perspective, when I was 322, I was a 3X, 4X. I was a size 20 pant. And now I can fit into even an extra large. So I can fit into extra large shirts. Some will be snug, some will fit perfect, some will be a little loose. It just depends on the cut. That's completely normal. But the fact that I can even try on an extra large in anything just makes me really, really excited. You guys would probably know the feeling, or, you know, have gone through something similar where you're just like, oh my God, I haven't been an extra large in forever, or never thought that you can fit certain sizes of clothing. So that's something that's really, really exciting. For pants, I bought a pair of leggings at Costco that was a size extra large. And I was like, these leggings are not gonna fit me. But like, I took one out and I stretched it and I was like, I think it might fit me. And it fits me absolutely perfect. Now, are those leggings, like, do they run big? I don't know, but who cares? To me, that's really, really exciting, because I'm sure at my highest weight, I would have never fit into those leggings. So little things like that make me really excited. I haven't tried number size pants. So like I said, I was a size 20 pant before, so I don't know what I am now. I don't think it's drastic. I might be like an 18. I don't think I'd get lower than that right now. Like, I don't think I'd fit into a 16, but who knows? I haven't tried it. I haven't been daring enough to try it. But actually, that's not true. I am daring. It's just that I was going to talk about this a little bit later, but I hate jeans and I hate certain pants now. Like, I only feel comfortable in leggings because they are form-fitting, and I feel like they're more flattering on me, because now jeans are getting so saggy, and regular pants get really saggy, especially the ones that I have. And I'm not going to spend money on a new set of clothes when I'm just going to grow out of them in a month or so. You get what I mean? So yeah, so I've just been not wearing the jeans, not wearing the pants, living in leggings pretty much. So yeah, so like I was saying, I haven't been liking jeans or regular pants. I've been living in leggings. And basically, it's because whenever I do wear the jeans that I have, they technically still fit. They just are very baggy in certain areas. Like, I'd have to wear a belt, or they sag on the crotch area or my butt area or my leg area, and it just makes me feel very uncomfortable to be in baggy clothes. It makes me feel very, very uncomfortable, very, very self-conscious, and I just really do not like it. So it's like giving me a thing right now. So I just feel more comfortable in leggings. Plus, leggings are pretty cheap and, you know, comfortable, so I really can't complain while I'm going through this. So yeah, so other things is, like, nothing pretty much fits in my wardrobe now. Shirts, like I said, pants, my jackets, everything is fitting very loose, very baggy, which is really, really exciting, but it's really annoying to walk out of the house and not feel comfortable in your own skin, and to walk around and feel like you're just walking around in baggy clothing. Like, people are going to think that's your style, which is not necessarily a bad thing, but if it's not your style, you're like, that's not what I want to portray myself as. You get what I mean? I hope that makes sense. So it's been like, a little bit of a struggle right now. It's a good struggle though. I'm not going to, you know, complain too much about it. So yeah, so I've gotten rid of a lot of clothes. I've donated them or given to family members things that don't fit me anymore, that are just too drastic for me. I've been trying to minimize my wardrobe as much as possible and just wear things like leggings and basic tees for now, because this, I do know and I understand that this is a temporary state. And I know that, again, because of watching videos and hearing stories. So I'm just trying to stay positive and keep it simple. Don't go too crazy when I go to a mall and think that I can buy certain things, because the temptation is real. Like, you start to fit into certain sizes and you're like, I want this, I want this, I want this that I've never had before. And it sucks when you want to do those things and you want to buy certain clothes, but you can't, because you're not going to be able to wear them in a couple weeks or a month. So it's like a waste of money, it's a waste of time. It's just, I'm not even going to bother to go through that. So yeah, I'm just trying to be a minimalist for now and keep things that fit me. When they don't fit me, get rid of them, donate them, give them away, and buy very, very inexpensive things to last me the next month. So shopping cheap sucks, but it's a great thing at the same time. You're not gonna get the clothes and the style that you want necessarily, but you know, you can still look cute on a budget and find things that will fit you for the time being. So like, I'll go to Walmart or Target or Marshalls or things like that where I can find cute things. I mean, I'm not gonna look like a bum walking out, but inexpensive things that, you know, that are just temporary. So I hope that makes sense. So yeah. I'm gonna be kind of like scatterbrained throughout this video because I didn't write any of my things down in like a particular order, so I might switch from different topics or go back to another topic. Just bear with me because I want to tell you guys like a lot. So a couple of non-scale victories, I just love to share those because not everything is about how much pounds you lose, how many inches you lose, things like that. I'm sure you guys are well aware that there's so many things that are like setbacks in life when you are a heavier person, and there's so many things that the rest of the world may not even think of as like an advantage, or I don't know if I'm making any sense, but there's certain things as a plus size person you really can't do that everyone else can do, and they don't really realize how much it sucks to not be able to do certain things. So I like to share non-scale victories, and I know some of you guys may be watching and you were like, oh my god, you know, I remember when I was able to do this for the first time, or I can't wait to do this for the first time, some of the struggles. So one thing I want to mention is I commute by train to work now, and I can't tell you how amazing it is to fit into a train seat. Like, I take the PATH, which is a train that goes from New Jersey to New York, and It's just amazing to fit in one seat. It's amazing to see one seat open and not worry like, oh, am I gonna fit there, or am I gonna squeeze the hell out of the people that are sitting next to that empty seat? And I know you guys know what I'm talking about. So to fit into a spot that you normally like wouldn't think twice about, you would just stand on the train instead of trying to shove your body somewhere where it doesn't fit, is an amazing thing. Going through a turnstile when you pay, like with your MetroCard to go into the station or out of the station, you know, just fitting a turnstile and not having to turn your body to the side and kind of jiggle your way through is an amazing feeling. And I've definitely noticed that, that I could just walk straight through. And it's like the little things like that that make me look back before surgery and just make me really appreciate what I've done for myself and really appreciate just the little things that now I'm able to do and get really excited for all the things that I'm going to be able to do in the future. So that's something else. So as you guys know or should know, I am a makeup artist and I work at Sephora right now. I work for myself. I have my own business, which is J. Sierra Beauty, and I'm a freelancer. But I also work at Sephora now, and we have a brush belt. Obviously, when you're a makeup artist and you do makeup on clients, they give you a little brush belt. When I first I got the brush belt, you know, it was just instinct to be like, crap, is this brush belt gonna fit me, or am I gonna have to ask for an extender? Am I gonna have to make a makeshift extender? Because that's happened to me before. Literally, I've had to make like ghetto DIY extenders for certain things to fit me. So that was the first thing that crossed my mind, like, is this belt gonna fit me? And it was the happiest, most surreal moment when I had to literally tighten my belt more because it was just too big on me. So it's just something like that that just makes me feel really, really excited about making this huge decision, about feeling better about myself and losing this weight, and like, you know, you guys know what I mean. Another thing is like crossbody bags. Like I said, I've done the DIY extender for a crossbody bag, and you know, now I don't have to. I have a crossbody bag that I want to take off my little DIY project that I put on it because I know it will fit me now. So just things like that I wanted to share with you guys. And I would love it if you guys have non-scale victories to share, because I love hearing everybody's non-scale victory. And I also take like a mental note and make a list so that I can try certain things that I wasn't able to do before and see if I can do them now. So yeah, I would love it if you guys would share that in the comments below, non-skill victories, things like that, or whatever you guys want to share that's very positive. Okay, let me get into some food. I have been stuck on certain foods this month. I haven't really been opening, I haven't really been creative with my food intake or trying new things, I should say. I've been sticking to what feels good and what just works for me right now, and then I'll kind of just do my trial and error as I go. But this month I would say I was very consistent with coffee. I usually have coffee and I put my protein in it. If I make it at home, I'll put one scoop of my protein powder that I showed you guys before. Or if I go to Dunkin' Donuts, I will bring one scoop with me and ask them to put it in my iced coffee. I'm very consistent with my fruit drinks. I've taken away more ingredients from my fruit drinks and kept it very, very simple. So basically what I'm doing now is I take my Nutribullet, I put frozen fruits, I put three of my bariatric vitamins in it, the tablets that are very chewable, and I put a bottle of water, and that's all I have. And it literally just makes a very natural fruit drink, and I have my vitamins crushed in. And that has been the most like healthy thing I can have. Like my body, I can't tell you guys, I physically and emotionally feel my stomach like really, really happy after I have that. Like I feel like my body is just like, thank you so much for feeding me this. Like I always feel energized. I always feel full. I feel like healthy and refreshed is what I'm trying to say when I have that drink. So if you're like in a lull where you're kind of doing the whole trial and error with food now post-op, and it is hard to still swallow, to overchew and do all these things, sometimes you just need that like that drink or something to go to that you know will like flush out your system, and you'll feel refreshed and hydrated and healthy and full and everything. And that my fruit drink does that for me. Like I really feel happy after I drink it. So I've been doing that. I've completely cut out eggs, real bacon, and avocados. Those things do not settle well with me. Oh, and bagels. These are things that I've loved pre-surgery and were my favorite foods. But I've learned that, you know, shit happens and your palate is going to change. And I thought I was going to be traumatized when it did. I'm not traumatized, because being sick after eating those foods is not fun. Like, you get the hot sweats. You feel like vomiting. You can't stomach certain foods, and that's okay. And I know it sucks because those used to be your favorite foods, like bacon was my favorite, avocados were my favorite, I ate eggs all the time, like bagels was one of my number one foods, like my top two foods, and I can't do it, my stomach hurts, it feels like it's stretching, it gives me pain, like I can't do it at all, like so I completely cut it out, and hopefully in the future I can stomach a little bit of it, but for right now I'm just not even gonna try it, so that's something that I completely cut out. Now, I try to eat a lot of chicken, so you want to keep intake with your protein, so you want to eat foods with that are high in protein, and if I'm not having a protein shake, I want to have like chicken or fish, and I'm not doing eggs anymore, so just, it's hard, and I'm not going to say that I do it, you know, as well as I should be doing it, you know, I'm talking about my protein intake, like I don't take what I should be taking in, but just try. I know it's really, really hard, just try. And I feel like chicken, no matter how it's done, is delicious and will help, you know, boost up that protein intake. I will say my sweet tooth has been going rampant. Like my sweet tooth is so it's going strong. It is going strong. And right now I'm like on this Dorito kick that you would not believe. And I wish I can kick it, but like, I don't know, for some reason I've been craving Doritos. I've even ate way too much where I'm like, oh, I'm gonna give it up. And then the next day it'll be like, damn, I just want a couple of chips. And I don't go OD and eat a whole family bag, like I physically can't. But, you know, chips aren't good for you. Once in a while, okay, but I've been ODing, so I definitely have to stop that. It's usually Doritos and then maybe like something to do with chocolate. Whether it's chocolate ice cream or a cookie or something to do with chocolate. But it's mainly Doritos, and I have to share. Like, maybe you guys have that one thing that you're like, damn, I can't get rid of that craving. And you know that chips and like potatoes and things like that kind of go down easy, and I don't know why. I guess the stomach doesn't have to digest it as much or take that much energy to digest it. So yeah, it sucks, but I'm gonna be real with you, like, I've been dying over Doritos. Okay, so next thing I want to talk about is vitamins. I am still keeping up with my vitamins. I take my 3 bariatric vitamins a day, or I try to take it every day. And I'm also taking biotin, and I was kind of on and off the biotin before, but now I'm definitely on a strict biotin diet, because I will say that I am losing a lot of my hair. It's not a drastic like loss, but I will say I'm losing more hair, and I don't want that to continue. So I'm gonna try to do my best to, you know, I'm going to try my best to find ways to grow my hair, keep my hair healthy, and stop it from falling out. So I will increase my biotin, and biotin is very good for hair, skin, and nails. So that's what I'm doing. What other vitamins do I take? I take my bariatric, which has my iron, my calcium, and everything all in one. So I do highly recommend you guys find a bariatric supplement instead of trying to do, you know, stuff from like GNC or like Walmart and stuff, and like having to take 3 or 4 pills a day, which is completely unnecessary. You can have it all in one. So I definitely recommend you do that. One thing, some struggles actually that I wanted to talk about is, yes, I am still constipated. That has not gone away. I am 4 months post-op, and I think it's my water intake that keeps me kind of constipated when I want to go. I don't go every day. I go maybe every other day or every 2 days. So it's happening more frequently, which I know from my previous videos, I've told you guys that before, when I had the surgery, I didn't go for like weeks on end. But so now I'm not experiencing that. Now I go more frequent than I was before, but it's still kind of a struggle to go, and it can be kind of painful. I haven't taken any laxative or things like that, which I should, because it will help me. But I just wanted to let you guys know that was still a struggle of mine, in case you are going through the same thing. Or if you have any recommendations on what I should do, please leave it down in the comments below. I still eat way too fast, and I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. That is such a hard habit to break. It is so, so hard. I really didn't think it was going to be this hard. But I have to stop and chew my food. I have to continuously chew and chew and chew and chew and get better at that, because I eat way too fast, and I do make myself not sick, but I can feel it, and it feels rough going down. So that's something I have to work on. And also my water intake. I have to drink more water a day. I've been getting better though. I have slowly but surely been getting better with my water intake. But I will tell you guys, from the videos I've seen, the stories I've heard, it's a pretty big struggle for everyone to have that good water intake. Even 3, 5, 10 years post-op, it's really hard. So just keep that in mind, and that you're not alone. And I think regular people struggle with drinking the amount of water you should be drinking, but when you do have a good day where you get that 64 ounces in a day, you definitely feel it. You feel the difference. You feel way more energetic. You feel way more plump. Your skin kind of radiates more. It's just a really good thing. Water is an amazing thing for your body. So yeah, so another struggle is this stupid gym. I say this in every video now. I feel like I'm getting repetitive that I do not go to the gym, which is terrible. But I have been more active. I work on my feet. I work a lot. And I have been more active forcefully, but that's a great thing. And I will say that I feel much better, that I'm way more active now. I'm still making it, you know, I'm making it a priority to go to the gym. And I will get there slowly but surely, which is how I work. But I will get there and I will develop a routine. I know I will. But I need to do that. If you guys have any suggestions on easy ways to ease back into a gym routine, or things I can do at home that kind of get me pumped to go to the gym, please leave it down below. Any kind of suggestions will help. Overall, I know this is random, but overall I have less body, foot, and back pain, which I'm sure some of you guys can relate. When you are overweight, it takes a toll on your bones. It takes a toll on your body and on everything, really. And it can hurt to walk. It can hurt to get up from a seat. It can hurt to sit down. It can hurt to go upstairs. It's just a constant battle. And I will say, 4 months post-op, it's a drastic, drastic change in the way I feel and my body, my feet, my back, and how they react to my everyday kind of routine. And it is no way, shape, or form as bad as it was pre-op. So that's really good. Another random thing I wanted to tell you guys. So like I said before, I was losing inches, and that's amazing. The more the merrier. Like, I want to continue to lose and see how different I'm going to look. But one thing I'm not happy about losing is my boobs. And I really thought I was going to be the exception, because doctors had said in the past, you know, oh, I think that's, you know, your real boob tissue. It's not just fat. No, they're going down. And they're going down pretty fast. As fast as my face. That's one thing I noticed, like a drastic change right away, is my boobs. And I've spoken to a friend of mine and she said the same thing. She's like, girl, it's just something you gotta deal with. And I'm dealing with it. I mean, it's not crazy right now, but it's getting crazy. And I'm like worried if I'm just gonna end up with deflated balloons. But hey, hopefully that becomes the trend of the year because I'm right on track. But yeah, I just wanted to tell you guys that, to keep an eye out for my ladies out there. That might be something you have to think about. And the last thing I wanted to talk about was style change. I should have mentioned this when I was talking about clothes and things, but I've noticed when I have been out shopping, well, really window shopping, my style has drastically changed. There's certain things that I look at and I'm like, no, that's what the fat me would wear, because that would hide certain areas that I do not want to hide anymore. And I know most of you guys can relate to that way of thinking. That you pick out certain items that will flatter your body at the time. And different things flatter my body now. Different things I'm more comfortable showing now. So it was very, very interesting to like catch myself in one of those moments and be like, wow, that's not something I would wear right now. That's something the bigger me would wear. And I don't need to wear something like this anymore. So my style is definitely changing, and I'm very, very, very excited about that, because I am a very creative mind, and not to brag or anything, no, but I am a very creative kind of person, and I do that, I express that with fashion and makeup, and especially makeup. But now I can incorporate more fashion, I feel, because I can fit more things and I can try different things and I can feel more comfortable in certain things. So I'm very, very excited to express myself in that way too. So I don't think I have anything else to say to you guys, but please, I know you guys have been wonderful in the comments. Some new subscribers have been absolutely amazing, and welcome, and thank you for watching my videos. Thank you for sharing the love and letting me know that my videos have helped you or that you enjoyed them. It really means the world to me. And I just hope that, you know, I'm kind of paying back, and I hope that more of you guys really like my videos and are enjoying the process if you're going through it with me. And I really, really appreciate you guys watching my video. It means so much. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you enjoy, and leave me a comment down below with any questions, concerns that you have about VSG, surgery, post-op, food, anything, makeup. You guys know I would answer. I would try my best to answer. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And until my next video, bye guys.